Check, check, check. Welcome to Cashion Wildcat Softball. Check, 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 mic 1, 2, 1, 2. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. All right, welcome to Cash and Wildcat Television here. I'm Neiman Abavi on Labor Day edition of softball here in Cashion, Oklahoma, where the Cashion Wildcats, led by Courtney Chambers, will be taking on the Hinton Comets, led by Garrett Hanna. The junior high team just finished up. It was a close one. I think, what was it, Nathan? 8-5 in five innings. Cashion Wildcats had a chance to, as the home team in the bottom of the fifth inning, to try to cut into that lead and possibly win, but they fell a little short, but a great job there by, who's the pitcher, JC, Jace, Bradley, oh my goodness, I threw my back out today, I'm sorry, I'm a little, maybe a little out of sorts, but we really appreciate you guys joining us here as the Cashion Wildcats finish up infield warm-ups. We've got games starting here very soon. I think we've got the national anthem, and we'll get started here any second.
Gateway Realty is a mother-daughter team that has a heart for small-town life. Both Anita and Kelly were born and raised in Cashion and are still raising their families here. Their family homesteaded in Cashion in 1908, and it's been home ever since. Anita and Kelly know this town, love this town, and would love to help make this your home too. For a friendly face and trustworthy knowledge, call these hometown girls at 405-641-7388. Go Wildcats! Cashion Shape Up Fitness is locally owned and operated with no contracts or sign-up fees. Our rates start at only $30 per month, and we have tanning available. Everything you need to work on your health and fitness. So contact Amber Lee to sign up today, 405 538-8248. And don't forget to check us out on Facebook, Cashion Shape Up Fitness.
I'm Todd Miller, and this is Grain & Grange, the coolest furniture store you've never heard of. Come see us.
Dr. Matt Dieselhorst at Dieselhorst Sports and Orthopedics can help you get game day ready. Dr. Dieselhorst works with athletes of all ages, taking a coordinated approach to accelerate return to play and maximize athletic performance. His work with pros in sports training, injury prevention, bracing, functional rehabilitation, and imaging works seamlessly with his medical and surgical expertise. Get started by going to Dieselhorst Sports and Orthopedics. Let Dr. Matt Dieselhorst get you back on the field, backing all Oklahoma athletes on the field and off.
At Maples Nixon Diesel Horse, we've helped a lot of people, and our goal was to treat each and every person like a friend. And as a friend, we've got your back always. We understand what you're going through. Being lawyers is what we do, but it's not all that we are. We care. We'll stand beside you throughout the entire legal process, not just as lawyers, but as your friends. We are Maples Nixon Diesel Horse, and we are here to help.
Have a pest problem? Call Rural Pest Solutions today. We offer as-needed services as well as a variety of treatment schedules. We're family-owned and operated, and we specialize in treating life's smallest problems. Spiders, ants, roaches, termites, mice, and more. For both residential and commercial, we're ready to solve your pest problems today. So call Rural Pest Solutions in Cashion, 405-238-6565. Proud supporter of Wildcat Athletes.
The pros with Squirtle Live. Find out more at squirtle.com/stream.
Thank you. pitcher and the catcher.
All right, here we go. All right, welcome to Cashion, Oklahoma, where we've got Labor Day action here on the softball field. Coach Chambers and the group is out here taking on the Hinton Comets. My man on the camera is Nathan Nabavi. We had a fight in the Nabavi family who was going to be the cameraman. It started with Brian, went to Nick, back to Nathan, and here we are. We've got Nathan on the camera. We've got Linnea here on the scoreboard. She's doing a great job from the junior high team. She gives a piece. She says, hello. And certainly welcome and happy to have you here on Cashion Wildcat TV here, powered by Squirtle. Starting lineups for, the lineup for the Cashion Wildcats. Lead off number 3, Ella Sumpkin. First base, Lauren Jenkins. I apologize. Second base, Emily Harrell, senior. Junior. Junior. Sophomore. Goodness gracious. I'm going to get it right. I apologize, Emily. I knew that. Emily Harrell, shortstop for us. Izzy Reeves, catcher. Junior, Ryan Ball, second base. Ryan Ball looks like, yes, will be at, looks like, we'll get this right. Ryan Ball, number 6. Lindsey Miller at third base. Lauren Lamb, center field. It looks like Ryan Ball may be in right field. We got Kenzie Wakefield batting 8th. She's designated hitter for Kaylee Duran, who'll be pitching. And then Maddie Bradley will be in left field, number 8. So, again, it's a great day. It's actually a really packed house. Folks showed up for Labor Day out here in Cashion, Oklahoma. And we're super excited to be broadcasting another Cashion Wildcat softball game. Again, I'm Neiman Abavi, missing my man Chris Gibson. We certainly enjoy seeing him on Friday nights with football. And we're super excited to be here on a Monday afternoon here of Labor Day to bring you some softball today. Coach Chambers, I'll get some records and kind of previous games here in a sec. We'll go to a quick timeout. Be right back here on Cashion Wildcat Television.
Gateway Realty is a mother-daughter team that has a heart for small-town life. Both Anita and Kelly were born and raised in Cashion and are still raising their families here. Their family homesteaded in Cashion in 1908, and it's been home ever since. Anita and Kelly know this town, love this town, and would love to help make this your home too. For a friendly face and trustworthy knowledge, call these hometown girls at 405-641-7388. Go Wildcats! Cashion Shape Up Fitness is locally owned and operated with no contracts or sign-up fees. Our rates start at only $30 per month, and we have tanning available. Everything you need to work on your health and fitness. So contact Amber Lee to sign up today, 405-538-8248. And don't forget to check us out on Facebook, Cashion Shape Up Fitness.
Off mute. Hey, welcome back to Cashion Wildcat TV. Here we've got coaches meeting at the center. We'll go ahead and cut to Nathan's camera. For some reason, it's not coming through. Make sure we don't have any. All right. We got it right there. Let's go ahead and cut to Nathan's camera. Nathan, good job, buddy. As the coaches are meeting in the middle, I wanted to review the Cashion Wildcat season thus far. 6-9 on the season. Basically coming off here, let's go ahead and cut over, basically coming off of a 12-2 loss to Welch just a few years ago. We had several rainouts and cancellations last week against Covington that would have maybe given the Wildcats add a few more wins with Kremlin Hillsdale as well as Covington Douglas. But nonetheless, we find ourselves here on September 7th, Monday, taking on two-way Hinton. Here trying to pick up win number 7 on the year. Coach Chambers with a very, very young team. No seniors on the team. Or is Kaylee's the senior, right? So Kaylee Duran, newly transferred in. Do you know where Kaylee came from? Don't know. So Kaylee coming in pitch, definitely needed to, with the loss of Reese Williams at pitcher, freshman, gives Lauren Jenkins a break, and certainly seeing good things here and heard good things about Kaylee Duran. We're super excited to have her here in the circle for the Cashion Wildcats. Okay, we've got Lindsay Miller at third, Ella Sumpkin at first. We've got Lauren Jenkins at 2. Sophomore Emily Harrell at short. Ryan Ball in right field. Lauren Lamb, the speedster with ice in her veins in center. And Maddie Bradley in left field. And I remember the last game we broadcasted against Crescent, Maddie had a couple big plays out in left field. So wind's blowing. What do we have, Nathan? Is it blowing in a little bit from the north? I think so. Yeah, maybe. Maybe a little bit from the northeast. We'll see what that does with the ball on the pitch. Nathan, can you zoom out a little bit for me, bud?
Yeah.
There we go. Perfect. Let's get the rubber all the way to the catcher. Be very good. We did not have a chance to set up our second camera via wireless. That will be coming in the mail here very soon, and we're going to be high-tech and 100% thanks to Coach Hardaway and all the great sponsors that we have here at with the administration here at Cashion Public Schools. Now, new camera coming in we'll have behind the backstop, and we'll have one here on the side, and it'll be straight legit for us during softball as we did with football the other night. All right. Well, we've got ball game started right here. Looks like number 2 will be leadoff for the Hinton Comets. Get her scored up and ready to go. Looks like she'll be batting from the left side. As we get Izzy Reeves at catcher. Certainly situations would lead off left side, looking for a slap bunt, maybe a slap hit. We'll see where she goes. Looks like she's gonna be hitting away from the box. First pitch, a little high, ball 1. Nice correction there by Kaylee, but still a little high. Ball 2. 2-0 count here, top of 1 here in Cashion. There it is. Nice correction there. First strike. 2-1. For Kaylee Duran. We'll get the story on her here in a sec. A 3-1 count. Cashing in their all whites, white pants, white tops. Maroon lettering, maroon numbers, gold outline. Ball 4, that'll be walked, so leadoff is able to get on first base for Hinton. This'll be a chance to watch. Be a chance to watch Izzy Reeves on the throwdown. We'll have Jenkins and Harrell on the cover. Number 15 for Hinton. Nice pitch, a little slap. That'll go foul. Strike 1. 2 lefties in a row for the Hinton Comets. If you don't watch softball a whole lot, that slap hit, slap bunt's one of the most dangerous things in the game, in my opinion. Pull back. Certainly on that bunt, we want to watch Lauren Jenkins cover first on that one as Ella and Lindsay chase the lines. Here, Cashion Wildcats, number 15, 2-hole hitter for the Hinton Comets. No outs, 2-2. Kaylee certainly relaxing here. Yeah, strike three. Out number one. Nice work there, little outside corner. That'll be out one, strike out one. Number 21 for Hinton up. A little high and outside. It's tight. Ball two, 2-0. Slap to two. Jenkins with a backhand, can't get it. That'll score a run. Good work there by Jenkins, covering a lot of dirt on that. Couldn't get to it in time, had a glove on it. Solid hit by 21, we'll give her the hit. And that'll score a run for the Hinton Comets. Bringing up number five, four-hole hitter. In the dirt, runner's going. Speedster, Harrell. Hey, great throw down by Reeves. Harrell on the cover. Runner is safe, though. Number 21 showing some excellent speed to get from first to second there. Hit towards short. Holds a runner. Run at one. Coming back for out one. Ella coming back, almost with the tag. So with that, if we weren't able to get that on the camera, Nathan, Sutkin's throw to third came off of Miller's glove, rolls into the dugout, and since the runner at two, number 21, had come past third, she's allowed an extra base, and another run is scored. Strike for Kaylee, coming back. Two-one count, two outs for the Cashion Walkouts, top of one. Pitches down and low, it's close. Nice work there by Duran. 2-2, I'm sorry, 3-1. Nice pitch, strike. Nice little change up there for number 11. Duran looking for her second strikeout here in the top of one. It's there, hit towards short. Emily Harrell's on it. Scoop and reach, it goes off the glove, a little high. Runner is safe. So it would have been out number three now, brings up number four for the Hinton Comets. Not sure if they're going to try to steal number 11 at first. Pitch, slap, it's up. Goodness. Miller was coming up for the slap bunt, and it pops right over her head. Tough situation there for the third baseman. Certainly would have had a chance to get that if she'd stayed at home. But she did the right thing coming up for that bunt. There's a ball, 1-1.
4-1-1.
Two outs here, top of one. Cashing down 0-2. Good pitch, slap. Jenkins slow on the cover. Great job by Ella Sunkin. Tag is there, boom, and the throw is out. Getting greedy there, number four, looking to get to two. No reason for that, but doesn't matter. Ball gets in quickly, Kaylee gets it, lurks back. Ella Sunkin on the cover at two, and we have the third out on a steal. And so with that, the side is out. bottom of one action coming up soon where your Cashion Wildcats are down 0-2.
I'm Todd Miller, and this is Grain & Grange, the coolest furniture store you've never heard of. Come see us.
Dr. Matt Dieselhorst at Dieselhorst Sports and Orthopedics can help you get game day ready. Dr. Dieselhorst works with athletes of all ages, taking a coordinated approach to accelerate return to play and maximize athletic performance. His work with pros in sports training, injury prevention, bracing, functional rehabilitation, and imaging works seamlessly with his medical and surgical expertise. Get started by going to Dieselhorst Sports and Orthopedics. Let Dr. Matt Dieselhorst get you back on the field, backing all Oklahoma athletes on the field and off.
At Maples Nixon Diesel Horse, we've helped a lot of people, and our goal was to treat each and every person like a friend. And as a friend, we've got your back all.
All right, welcome back to Cashion, Oklahoma, where we've got Cashion Wildcats softball. Cashion Wildcats against the Hinton Comets. Cashion finds himself down bottom of one, down 2-0. Lead off Ella Sunken, first base. Fastball pitch, strike one. Cashion did all right in the top of one, had a couple of errors that allowed a run or two here, but... Certainly good job by the Hinton Comets. Slap, Ella in the gap. Great job by Sunken. She's going to look for a two-bagger. She's going to be held up at two. Great leadoff there by Ella Sunken with a double. She served up the fastball. Ella Sunken said thank you and sent it in the left center gap for a two-bagger. Nice work there by the sophomore. Brings up number two, Lauren Jenkins, freshman, second base. High pitch, ball one. Low inside, ball two. Jenkins staying very patient. Ball three, 3-0 count here, 30-30. Ella Sumpkin at two. Jenkins most likely with a take here. High. Now they'll call the strike. 3-1, right take by Jenkins. Pitching for the Hinton Comets. We'll get a number here in a second. Inside, we're going to call strike two. Now hang tight there. Gomez pitching. So working all the way back, two straight strikes, full count for Jenkins, a freshman. Runner at two, Ella Sutkin. Pitch swing, nice job, nice cut there, fouls off the pitch. Full count for Jenkins. Pitch is there, a swing and a miss. Oh, number one. Nice work there by Jenkins, hanging tough. Quality at bat. That brings up Emily Harrell, sophomore, shortstop. Number four, on deck, Izzy Reeves. See, a base hit will certainly bring in a run here for the Cashion Wildcats. Swings, foul ball, inside handle. Pitch is a little high, tasty though. Nathan agrees. Oh, one count. Change up, little high. 1-1. One out here for the Cashion Wildcats. Ella Sumpkin at two. Ball two. 2-1. Ball three in the dirt. 3-1 count. Harrell's a hitter. She'll find one. You know, that's the one thing that Coach Chambers has. Young team, but they all can swing the stick and certainly can. There's a hit. First baseline. Looks like it will fall foul. Chambers is saying auto tag on that for Sumpkin to get over here. Sumpkin's speedster herself. She says, I got it, coach. I got you. Chambers always coaching. We got a good one here, folks. Full count for Harrell. Low and inside. That's ball four. And that'll be a walk for Emily Harrell as she trots to first base. Runners at 1-2 brings up four-hole Izzy Reeves. A lot of power here through the lineup for sure. Let's see if Izzy Reeves can find a gap as well, bring in a couple runs. Woo! That was a little high. She liked it though. That'll be strike one, foul off. Count one out here, bottom of one, Cashion down 2-0. Pitch, swing, foul ball. Izzy Reeves liking that stuff right at the letters. Down 0-2. Time to battle here, shorten it up. We've got Harrell at one, Sumpkin at two. Sumpkin with an absolute mash into the gap. Change up, swing, and miss. Good job there by Gomez. Getting out ahead of the count, throwing up that change up. And with that, that'll be a second strikeout here. Izzy Reeves will take a seat, bringing up Ryan Ball, second baseman. Second base person. Strike one. Gomez dialing it up for the Hinton Comets. Change up, a little high there. That was one of those things earlier for Izzy. You always want an aggressive hitter. Always want that in your four hole, especially with runners on. Would have liked for her to maybe be a little bit more picky on those high pitches. Another high pitch brings up 2-1, two balls here. Two outs, bottom of one, Cashion down 0-2. We've got runners at 1-2, we've got Sumpkin at two and Harrell at one. Gomez pitching for the Hinton Comets. Pitch in the dirt, low, 3-1. Is that 3-1, Nathan? Net 3-1? 3-0. Pitch is high. Take your base. Walk there for Ryan Ball. And that loads the bases up with Lindsey Miller. Sophomore looking to get some RBIs right now. Lindsey's got power. We've seen it. She's come up big in the past, just here on Cash and Wildcat TV in that game against Hennessy a few weeks ago. Pitch, swing, foul. Good cut. Right idea. On deck, we've got junior Lauren Lamb, number 5, center fielder. Bases are loaded. We've got ball at 1, Harrell at 2, Sumpkin at 3. Anything in play is going to get a run on the board for the Cashion Wildcats. Swing. Right idea. Gomez throwing 2 strikes. Coach Chambers telling us to stay calm. 0-2, 2 outs. Dugout telling him to watch out for that changeup. There it is, outside. Oh, he wants to call it? No, okay, good for you, sir. 1-2. Swing, foul ball. Nice work. 1-2 count. Would have thought Gomez would have kept that one low and outside, but she came back in. Lindsay Miller found it, and that may be the right recipe for her. She gets a little bat on the ball there. 1-2, 2 outs. Miller battling here, number 11, third baseman. Change up in the dirt. Good block there by the catcher. Kirchhoff, number 21. Brings up 2-2 count, 2 outs. 0-2. Cashin's down. Swing and a miss. That's strike 3 for 2 outs. Strands 3. Not ideal for the Cashin Wildcats, but certainly gives hope in terms of future innings down the road. So with that, we'll go to a quick timeout where your Cashin Wildcats are down 0-2 as we go to top of 2 action.
Please. We understand what you're going through. Being lawyers is what we do, but it's not all that we are. We care. We'll stand beside you throughout the entire legal process, not just as lawyers, but as your friends. We are Maples, Nix, and Diesel Horst, and we are here to help.
Have a pest problem? Call Rural Pest Solutions today. We offer as-needed services as well as a variety of treatment schedules. We're family-owned and operated, and we specialize in treating life's smallest problems. Spiders, ants, roaches, termites, mice, and more. For both residential and commercial, we're ready to solve your pest problems today. So call Rural Pest Solutions in Cashion, 405-238-6565. Proud supporter of Wildcat Athletes.
Zoom in right there, Nathan. You can get in. There's no action going on. Right. You can follow Izzy as she goes to the...
1-2. No, that's not right.
4-3-1. All right, welcome back to action here. Softball, Cashion style. Live from Cashion, Oklahoma. Cashion Wildcat TV here, and the Cashion Wildcats find themselves down 0-2, top of 2, to the Hinton Comets. First pitch foul, Kaylee Duran. Coming in to pitch. Gets out ahead, 0-1. Second pitch in the dirt for ball 1. Cashin had runners. We had bases loaded. Had a chance to bring in a couple of runs. Kudos to Gomez, pitcher for Hinton. A little mix of change-ups and fastballs. Able to get a couple strikeouts. Actually, 3 hits left. Maddie Bradley back, hits the wall. Maddie gets it in, gets a double there on the leadoff hit by number 3, Weathers. Brings up number 9, Denny. Swing miss, Lindsay Miller there, holds the runner, gets the out at 1, and as the dugout yells for Sunken to eat it, number 3, Weathers is able to advance to third base on the hit, but that does bring up out number 1. Good job by Miller finding that ball. Brings up number 7, Barrett, little slap hit. First pitch strike, 0-1, one out. Comes it in. How's that not a strike? Yeah, it's still a strike. Nope. 1-1. Pitch is there, there's a strike. 1-2. Barrett's not sure of herself, but certainly it's tough. Back of the box. 1-2, one out. Looking for a K. Slap, hit to Jenkins. She got the speed. She's safe, goes four. Miss. Runner will go two, and that'll bring in a run. So good speed there by Barrett. She was able to find the spot on the slap. Fast enough down the line to make it to first in time. Is able to beat out the throw from Jenkins to Sumpkin. Throw back to home to try to get the runner is off. And that sends Barrett all the way to second base. One out, scores a run. First pitch strike, nice job there by Duran. Number two. Don't have her number. I'm guessing that's Snow, possibly. Hit down the first baseline. Big monster hit. I have to say, let that one go. Nice power there by number two. Set on that inside pitch. Nonetheless, it's still a strike. One out. 3-0 cashing down now. O-2 for number two. Duran looking for her second out here. Good spot. 1-2 count here. Runner at two, number seven, Barrett. Hit, cut. Nice job, look what I found. Da-da-da, da-da-da. Duran with the snag. Line drive brings up out number two, and we're back at the top of the order. Actually, that was, I'm sorry, I apologize. That was Wheeler, number two. Brings up number 15, two outs here for the Cashion Wildcats. There should be a strike. Yeah, a little outside, I guess. Gomez, the pitcher, trying to help herself out. Runner at two, two outs. Whoever's out there in Squirtle Land managing the scoreboard for me, thank you so much. I appreciate you. Hit down first baseline. Sutton's there for the easy out, number three. And that ends aside for the Hinton Comets, but they were able to get one run. And they lead 3-0. Let's see if the Cashion Wildcats will have a chance to come back and get some runners on, get some runs up here. Left stranded three last inning. See if they can make it work here. We'll go to a quick timeout. Thanks for joining us here on Cashion Wildcat TV.
With Squirtle Live. Find out more at squirtle.com/stream.
welcome back to Cashion, Oklahoma, Cashion Wildcat TV. Softball action today on Labor Day. I'm Eamon Abavi. Joining me on the camera is my man Nathan Abavi. Cashion finds himself down 0-3 here, bottom of two. The hitting's been there for the Cashion Wildcats. The runs have not. Lauren Lamb lead off here, number five. Junior center fielder takes ball one, first pitch from Gomez. Ball two. That looked tasty, didn't it, Nathan? I don't know if you were watching. I would have swung at that one. Swing, third base line. Scoop in and out. Nice work there by Lamb to put it in play. The third baseman was there. Great throw. It'll be out number one. And that brings up Kenzie Wakefield, DH. On deck is Maddie Bradley. Swing mash down the first baseline. It's going to drop. Fair ball for Kenzie Wakefield. She's going to look to maybe get to two, if not three. Coach will hold her up. A nice start there. Nice little double, stand-up double for Kenzie Wakefield. Great shot down the first baseline. And we've got a runner. Maddie Bradley on deck. We've got, looks like, is it Ella Sutkin? Sure do. Top of the lineup coming right up here on deck. First pitch strike. Swing. Strike two. Two count. High. Ball one. 1-2 for Bradley. We've got Wakefield on two after a smash down the first baseline. Cash has got one out. Down 0-3 here, bottom of two action. Swing, miss. Got a foul ball. Hit right off of Bradley's knee. Right idea there on that one. Staying aggressive. Dugout urging her on. Hey, hit by pitch, that'll work. Bradley finds herself trotting down the first base. Says, no problem, can't hurt me. HBP. And that brings up Ella Sumpkin leadoff here. Bottom of two, Cashin finds himself down 0-3 with one out here. Runners at first and second. Wakefield with a monster hit down the first baseline, hit by pitch. Maddie Bradley trots down the first base. The lefty now, sophomore, had a huge hit in the first inning. Outside pitch for ball one. Absolutely catapulted it to the left center. Was able to get a stand-up double on the play. Outside, ball two. Gomez, remembering that hit from the first inning, probably's like, I'm going to stay away from Sutkin. Let's see if she serves one up over the plate here. She does. That'll be a first strike. 2-1. It's a little high. I don't think Sun can like that. High. Ball three. 31. One out. Cashin looking to either get a run here or load the bases for Lauren Jenkins on deck. Swing. She liked it. Full count for the sophomore first baseman. Certainly not worried about the hit. Just going to see where it goes here. Let's see what happens. Ball four, bases loaded. Cashion seen this story before here, the bottom of one. Cashion strain at three. One out this time here with Sumpkin at one, Bradley at two, and Wakefield on three after a monster hit down the first baseline. Brings up freshman Lauren Jenkins. Jenkins with the strikeout earlier in the game. Hit down the first baseline, they'll squeeze through, they'll score one. Bradley's going home. She'll score two, and Jenkins, just like that, two RBIs. Nice work there by the freshman. Great spot. And that scores, that scores Kenzie Wakefield as well as Maddie Bradley. Ella Sumpkin moves to three, and that's a timeout as Coach Garrett Hanna wants to talk to Gomez and the team. The offense has been there, Nathan. The offense has been there for the Cash and Wildcats. It's just anything you can do, buddy. If you can get the score, that would be good. You can zoom. You can always zoom out and get more. Do a little coaching there on the camera work. We need my man Mark Perrin up here. Mark and Gage Bennett do a good job for us on the football broadcast. Hi, how are you? Yeah, are you sure? No. So just like that, the Cash and Wildcats put two up on the board, one out on a two RBI slap down the first base line by Lauren Jenkins. Runners at the corner. We've got sophomore Emily Harrell, shortstop, up to bat number four. Most likely a take, get that runner over. Hit, right, first base line, is it gonna drop? Just foul. Inches away, Harrell would have had an RBI there. Cashin's certainly liking that first base side. That'll bring up a strike though. One out here, bottom of two action here. Cashin down 2-3. Runners at first and third for the Wildcats, one out. Got to Izzy Reeves on deck. Swing, it's a hit. Foul ball, first base. Wind carried it over the fence this time. Powers there. She's on the button. She's got to straighten it out, find a gap. Two strikes, 0-2, one out. Cashing down 2-3. We've got Harrell at Harrell up to bat. Sumpkin at three. Jenkins at one. Pitch is high. Ball one. Came back with that changeup. We've seen Gomez get up 0-2, throw that changeup every single time. Certainly something the Cash and Wildcats have paid attention to. Pitched. Ah. Inside, that'll be strike three for Emily Harrell, who earlier in the game had a walk. That brings up out two, and that brings up catcher Izzy Reeves. Ryan Ball on deck. Again, Cashin with runners in position. Just need that timely hit to get that run across. Change up. With the take, gets Jenkins over to two. You're right, Emily. Oh, 1 for Reeves. Second pitch is high for ball one. Izzy with a strikeout in the first inning, looking to change her fortunes here in the bottom of two. Low and inside, ball two, 2-1. Coach Chambers cheering her on, encouraging her to stay mad, stay angry. In the dirt for ball three, brings up 3-1, two outs. Jenkins at two, Sumpkin at three. I promise you, Izzy's looking to hit here. She ain't looking for the walk. Pitch, swing, smash over the right fielder's head. That'll bring in Sunken. Jenkins gets waved in. There's another one. And coach holds up Izzy Reeves on a monster mash to right field. Nice work there by the catcher. You knew she was going to get on court to let that one go. And that scores two. Nice work there by Izzy Reeves with the big time double. Two out double, I might say. Brings up Ryan Ball. And just like that, Cashion takes the lead as Sunken and Jenkins come in. First pitch strike. Ball, who also had a walk in the first inning. Change up. Outside, nice eye. What a monster hit by Reeves. Just absolutely smashed it over the right fielder's head against the wind. Swing and miss. Good swing there. Right idea for a ball on that last pitch. That brings up strike two. One and two here. Two outs. Bottom of two. Cashion up 4-3. Ryan Ball looking to get a hit to move Reeves over. Possibly score. Change up. Woo. Outside. 2-2. Two outs. That last one looked pretty nasty. Pitch, low, inside, full count. Ball fighting it off here. Inside, low, that's ball four, that's a walk. As Ryan Ball trots to first base, got runners at first and second, brings up Lindsey Miller, third base. What was a fast start for Gomez is now kind of slowed down for her. Lindsey Miller. That's ball one on first pitch there for Miller. Runners at first and second, two outs. Lindsey Miller up to bat, sophomore, third baseman. On deck, Lauren Lamb. Pitch is high, smash right at the pitcher. She's on base. Did that hurt? That had to have hurt. She literally did not move. Gomez not moving, puts a smile on. That is one tough lady. Took one right off the thigh. Lindsey Miller absolutely destroyed that ball. And she finds herself safe at first. Base is loaded again for the Cashion Wildcats, bringing up junior Lauren Lamb, center fielder. We've got Miller at first, Ball at two, Reeves at three. On deck, we've got Kenzie Wakefield, who started this all off. Huge hit down to first base. And with that, Gomez got to get that thing checked out. That thing had to hurt. It's like she's looking at her wrist as well. She didn't flinch, though. I'll tell you what. If you don't think softball players are tough, rewind that last hit. So new pitcher out, number three, Weathers, for Hinton. With that, we'll go to a quick timeout. We'll be right back here on Cashion Wildcat TV as your Cashion Wildcats take the lead here at the bottom of two, 4-3. Welcome back to Cashion, Oklahoma, where your Cashion Wildcat softballers are up 4-3 here, bottom of two action. Lauren Lamb up to bats. Change of pitchers here. Weathers coming out to replace Gomez. And first pitch in the dirt for ball one. Two outs here. We got bases loaded again for the Cashion Wildcats. They took advantage of it earlier in the inning. Let's see if they can continue that ride. Swing. Lamb. She knows it. She swung out of that one. She wanted to hit it. We'll give her kudos on that one. Keep your chin down, find the ball next time. 1-1, two outs. Number five. Reeves coming home on the pass ball. She is safe. Nice work and recognition by the catcher. She says, I got this, coach. Comes in on the, we'll call that actually a wild pitch by Weathers. That'll be ball two, 2-1. That'll bring in a run. 5-3 Cashion here at bottom of two. It's been a great inning for the Cashion Wildcats. Falling down 2-0. Hold the Hinton Comets to no runs in the top of two and come back and unleashed five runs. Ball three in the dirt. 3-1 here for Lauren Lamb. We've got runners at two and three. Miller at two. Ball at three. Hit. Drops in the gap. That'll score a run. Miller will come down the line. She'll be held by Chambers. And just like that, a sweet little hit there by Lauren Lamb. Little bleed there. Falls in. Scores in another run. And Cashin keeps the onslaught going. Huh? What? Thank you, Nathan. Kenzie Wakefield, who started this inning for us. Speedster Lamb with the steal. No throw. Got runners at two and three now. Kenzie Wakefield, who started this off for us with a huge hit down the first inning, finds herself back up to bat. Hit down the first base line. First baseman got it. And that'll be out number three there, but not without giving up six runs as the Cashion Wildcats pour it on. I apologize. Hinton did put down a run there in the second inning, but with that, Cashion up 6-3. Big inning for the Cashion Wildcats, and we'll go to a quick timeout here on Cashion Wildcat TV, powered by Score. I'm Nathan Abavi. Nathan Abavi on the camera. It's a good one. If you're not if you're out there watching, that's great. We'd love to have you come out here and watch it in person. We've got a packed house here supporting the Cashion Wildcat softball team here on Labor Day. We've got a quick commercial. We'll be right back.
Way Realty is a mother-daughter team that has a heart for small-town life. Both Anita and Kelly were born and raised in Cashion and are still raising their families here. Their family homesteaded in Cashion in 1908, and it's been home ever since. Anita and Kelly know this town, love this town, and would love to help make this your home, too. For a friendly face and trustworthy knowledge, call these hometown girls at 405-641-7388. Go Wildcats!
All right, I'm Eamon Abavi. Welcome back to Cashion Wildcat TV here from Cashion, Oklahoma, with your Cashion Wildcats are up 6-3 over the visiting Hinton Comets, coached by Garrett Hanna. Big inning for the Wildcats as they batted around, were able to get six runs. Put a lot of pressure now back on the Hinton Comets to catch up. Leadoff for the Comets is number 21, three-hole hitter, Kurlhoff. Kaylee Duran pitching for the Cashion Wildcats on the day so far has one strikeout, a couple of walks. Defense pop up to Maddie. It'll drop right in front of her. She's come up, she'll glove it. Maddie playing deep on that last ball, don't blame her. Hitting's hit a couple deep. So with that leadoff in this inning for Hinton's able to get on with the hit, brings up number five, four-hole hitter Findley. Ball one. Pitch is high. The ball two. That advances the runner Kurlhoff. Number 21 is able to get to second base. So with that, no outs, top of three. 2-0 count for number five, Findley. 21 Kurlhoff, catcher for the Hinton Comets. Makes it a two, and that's strike one. Good job by Duran to come back. 2-1, no outs. Runner at two for Hinton. Pitch swing. Good job by Duran. 2-2. Al Loffer. Pitch number five there. Count stays 2-2, no outs. Good job there by Duran. Pop up, center field, Lamb chasing it. Comes up with a catch, Speedster gets that for out number one, holds a runner at two. Nice work there by Lauren Lamb, number five, the junior coming in strong with the underhand catch. And that brings up out number one. Up to bat, Malk, number 11 for the Hinton Comets. First pitch, low. Very close, ball one. One out here, top of three action for the Cashion Wildcats. Pop up, Jenkins has got it, carries it for out number two. Jenkins, silky smooth, throws the hat off, says, I don't need my visor, comes up, catches the ball, holds the runner at two, and just like that, we've got two outs. Nice work there by the infield. Brings up Dallenberg. Dallenberg, number four. Left side, she was a sloppy slappy last time. I believe she was able to get on with error. Nice snag there by Reeves, but nonetheless, number 21, who's got some wheels, able to make it from second to third. In scoring position, number four, Dalberg, was able to reach on a little, nice little slap towards the first base. No cover was there. Outside for ball two. Swing and a miss in the dirt. Gets a strike. Certainly be coming down, looking to come down the third base line here the way her stance was last time on that slap. Try to see if she can't get on and maybe score that run. Pitch down. Duran with the third out. And that'll end the side as the Hinton Comets strand one. And Kaylee Duran hanging tight there with the out. And that'll bring up bottom of three action here from Cashion, Oklahoma, where your Cashion Wildcats hold the Hinton Comets scoreless in that inning and retain a 6-3 lead. We'll go to a quick timeout. Be right back here on Cashion Wildcat TV.
Cashion Shape Up Fitness is locally owned and operated with no contracts or sign-up fees. Our rates start at only $30 per month, and we have tanning available. Everything you need to work on your health and fitness. So contact Amber Lee to sign up today, 405-538-8248. And don't forget to check us out on Facebook, Cashion Shape Up Fitness.
All right, welcome back to Cashion, Oklahoma, where your Cashion Wildcats are up 6-3 on the Hinton Comets. An explosion in the top of, or the bottom of two. Cashion scoring six runs, loading the bases a few times, doing their work on deep shots, shots of the gap. See if we keep it going here as Maddie Bradley, left fielder, is up to bat here leading off top of, or bottom of three. Ball one. Maddie with a hit by pitch last time. Yeah, it was low inside, but they'll call strike there. 1-1 for Bradley. And as you know, here on Cashion Wildcat TV, we're a bit of a homer, so we'll sit and talk about balls and strikes because we can. But we know nobody will take offense to it. Bradley swings the high pitch, fouls it off. 1-2. Strike three. Nice pitch there by number three. Weather, she's on that inside. Bradley will be out number one. That brings up Ella Sumpkin leadoff, who had a monster double in the first inning, had a walk in the second. A little behind on that bunt. She caught that one late in the plate. So that one's fouled off. Strike one, one out. Cashing up 6-3 here, bottom of three. Looks like we'll see Ella hit away here. Outside, ball one, 1-1. Good eye there by Sumpkin, the sophomore. High for ball two. Swing, strike two. Hey. One, 2-2 count for Sumpkin. One out. High swing, fouls it off. Staying alive, quality at bat for the sophomore. We're going to ton of pitches here by Weathers. See what she comes back. Big swing, slapped a pitcher, and that'll be out number two. Good work there by Weathers, staying calm. Now bring up Lauren Jenkins, second base. Who had a huge hit, bringing in two runs, kind of started the onslaught for the Cashion Wildcats last inning. She's had a strike in the first inning, a huge hit in the second. She'll take strike one here, two outs. Gomez definitely warming up, or I'm sorry, Weather's definitely warming up. Ball one, good eye. On deck is three-hole hitter Emily Harrell. Hit near the second base. Nice stop by the second baseman. Well hit ball there by Jenkins. Great stop by the second baseman. And I'll bring up third out in the end for the Cashion Wildcats here as we move to top of four action. Cashion still up 6-3.
I'm Todd Miller, and this is Grain & Grange, the coolest furniture store you've never heard of. Come see us.
Dr. Matt Dieselhorst at Dieselhorst Sports and Orthopedics can help you get game day ready. Dr. Dieselhorst works with athletes of all ages, taking a coordinated approach to accelerate return to play and maximize athletic performance. His work with pros in sports training, injury prevention, bracing, functional rehabilitation, and imaging works seamlessly with his medical...
All right, welcome back to Cashion. With the Cashion Wildcats, finding themselves up 6-3 here. Going to the top of four.
Over your head!
Number three leadoff, we'll be leading off Weathers, the pitcher for the Comets.
Maddie, thank you!
In the second inning.
chance to get three runs here. Pitched, third base line. Now ball. That'll bring up strike number one. I want to make sure and thank some of our sponsors here while we're waiting for the ball. I mean, Chief of Fitness, Daniel Reed, Gateway Realty with Anita and Kelly, and obviously Todd Miller out there at Rain and Graves. We appreciate the sponsorship here, Cashion Athletics and CWTV. The Rams, pitch, swing, strike. Oh, 1-2 count here, no outs for Weathers. Lead off for the Hinton Comets here, top of four. Cashion at 16. Ball two, 2-2 count. Already in it. Pop up, pitch there. Nice work. Face 2-2. Pitch, hit, into the gap. Shot there, landed there on the chase down. Not fast enough there. It was a great shot, perfect spot there for Weathers.
Blue, courtesy. Blue.
As, Coach Hannah will ask for courtesy for her pitcher. That'll bring in, looks like, number one. So, lead off hit there by Weathers. Should take a seat. Brings in Denny, number nine. No outs. Pitch, swing. Right past Harold. Man, they didn't carry center field. Great hit there. First pitch hit. There by number nine, Debbie. Solid hit. Now we got runners at first and second with no outs. Jordan threatening. Brings up number seven, Barrett.
Hey, wipe it off, Emily, all right?
Not sure what Coach Hannah is talking. So with this quick timeout, while we've got a coaches discussion with the umpire, we'll go ahead and begin. Do to give thanks to our awesome sponsors, Cashion Clinic, Cameron Hogan, my man. I know Chris Gibson's probably watching. I know you are, Chris, over there at Legacy Insurance. Rural Pest Solutions, Jesse McCracken does a great job, and I'll see the side hustle there with his snow cone truck. Pioneer Electric, Diesel Horse Sports in North Phoenix, Coffee Creek Church, Maple Links, and Diesel Horse Interest Insurance Agency. And of course, big thanks to all of our Cashion Horse Sports sponsors. To make sure that we've got great equipment and new homes and our sports programs and spots to compete. Not sure what the conversation is about, but nonetheless, we've got number seven, Barrett, up to bat, who had a hit on the last at bat, the bottom or the top of two. First swing pitch, very foul, strike one. Runners at first and second for Barrett. No outs. Ran in a circle. Strike two. Nice job there by Durant. 0-2 count. Well ahead.
Let's go.
Hit to left. Matty Browning chasing it down with the catch. In and out of the front. And a chance for a three. That was a little off. Could have gotten a first. Just like that. Hit the timer. Got bases loaded. Strike one, good job.
I've been on mute this whole time. Goodness gracious. Hit down the first baseline, barely foul ball. Huge hit there by Wheeler. Sorry about that, I've been on mute this whole time. That's always a disaster. Why, are you laughing at me, Nathan? It's okay. I'm sure you guys heard me. Who knows? But just like that, we've got bases loaded for the Hinton Comets. No, one out. Hit deep right field. That has a chance, and it's gone. Grand slam. I should have stayed. Nathan was saying I should have stayed on mute. I should have. Absolutely rips that shot over right field. She was close on that first one and absolutely put one over. And no doubt as it was heading towards the fence. So just like that, four-run shot. Hinton Comets have got seven on the board now. Cashion clearly still in the game. No worries here. Duran just needs to keep pitching. Defense needs to keep going. Gomez up to bat. She started off pitching for the Hinton Comets. I think she moved out to left field. Was replaced by Weathers. No outs. Yeah, strike there. So Duran there. So in the dirt for a ball. Big smash there by Wheeler. Grand slam to the right side. That'll be ball four, walk. So as Gomez walks down first baseline, that brings up Kurloff, number 21 catcher, who has a hit, has two hits on the day, first and third inning. As well as a run. Cashion looking for their first out here in this inning. Pop up. It's got a chance. It's going to fall. Perfect spot there for number 21, Kurloff, who gets another hit on the day. So we've got a quick change here. It looks like Rayleigh Nance will be coming out. She'll be going to right field. Ryan Ball will be coming to left field. No outs. Runners at first and second for the Comets. Up 7-6 now. Top of four. Number five, Finley's up to bat. Pitch. Pop up. Reeves has got a chance, and the out. Great job there by Sumpkin on the find. Great hustle there by Reeves, and that'll be out number one for the inning. That'll bring up number 11, Malk, who reached on error in the first inning and had a hit out in the third. Ground ball was short, I believe, last time she was up. First batch. Pitch in the dirt. Good job by Reeves to find it. Ball one. Low for ball two. You know, that last shot there, that last hit, that's a tough one, but certainly in a situation where Harrell's trying to track it down, we definitely need your outfielders coming in for that as well, as the runners were frozen. Could have gotten that out at three on the force. As runners were tagging. Looks like pitch was a strike. Brings up 2-1, one out. Swing, foul ball. Three-two. That'll be ball four for a walk. Now load the bases for the Hinton Comets. We already put a four spot up on a grand slam. One out, bases loaded. Number four up to bat, Dahlberg, who again reached on error and and had an out in the third inning. Looks like we've got a replacement here, number 14. Replacing Dahlberg here. Changing up a little bit of bunt slap for maybe a little power here for Coach Hannah. Pitch, first pitch. Looks like it was close to a strike with ball. 1-0, one out. Top of four. Cashing down 7-6. Swing, foul ball. Big third baseline, force it home. Throw from Lindsey Miller. Good stop by Miller. A little bit low to the outside. Dropped by Izzy Reeves. Izzy Reeves isn't able to get back to the home plate to get the force. Now we'll get in a run. And I'll bring up number three. Still one out. Hit down to first base. Alessandro will go home. There's another drop ball at home. Certainly been a tough inning for the Cashion Wildcats. Several innings, several errors on the day, which could have limited the scores. Fielder's choice on that last one is not an out as well, so. Strike, 1-1, Rand coming back. Swing, strike two. Denny, number nine, up to bat. 2-2 count, one out here. Cashing down 9-6, top of four. Pitch, swing, pop up. Sunken chasing it down. Nice job there by Sunken with another out. Two outs now. Bases loaded for hitting comments. Brings up number seven, Barrett, who earlier in this inning got reached on E7. Pitch, hit by pitch. Living life right for Barrett. Brings in a run. And Wheeler up to bat, who had a grand slam earlier. He's got a chance for another one. That's a strike. Has there ever been two grand slams hit in one inning? I'm sure that's happened before. Let's hope we double jinx her here on Cash and Wildcat TV. Swing, smash, right field, in the gap. Coming in. Randy Nance with a stop, not after it drives in two more runs. Have lost track. And with that, we've got runners at first and third. Cashing down 12-6 here, which was basically a nine-run inning thus far. Two outs. Number 15 up to bat, Gomez. Oh, high pitch going home. It's not there. Runner comes in on the pass ball. Nice backup there. Nice work by Harrell on the throw back to third. And that'll score another run. Number 15, Gomez up to bat. It's a slap. Looks like it'll be ball one. Or ball two, I apologize. 2-0. Two outs. Cashion desperately wanting to get out of this inning. In the dirt. It's stopped there by Reeves. Hey, ball four walk. Runners at the corner there. Brings up number five, Finley, who had the first out, I believe, of the inning. Huh? 21, my apologies. Curl off. Showing bunt, pull back, runner two. No cover at three, should have been there. Good job on the cutoff there by Emily Harrell. Nice throw from Reeves, looking to get that runner at third. She was asleep. Certainly young team will learn from that. Change up. In the dirt, drive by Reeves. So number two, Wheeler on the pass ball, staying aggressive. Sometimes when you're up big, you get to take chances that you don't totally take in a game. And Reeves said, trying to get back on the ball. Umpire calls her safe, and that'll bring another run. Still two outs here, 2-0. Hit. Harrell with the ball and the out. Nice job there to close out the inning, but not until the Hinton Comets put up a 12th spot. So that we have a good timeout. Be right back.
And surgical expertise. Get started by going to Diesel Horse Sports and Orthopedics. Let Dr. Matt Diesel Horse get you back on the field, backing all Oklahoma athletes on the field and off.
At Maples Nixon Diesel Horse, we've helped a lot of people, and our goal was to treat each and every person like a friend. And as a friend, we've got your back, always. We understand what you're going through. Being lawyers is what we do, but it's not all that we are. We care. We'll stand beside you throughout the entire legal process, not just as lawyers, but as your friends. We are Maples Nixon Diesel Horse, and we are here to help.
Have a pest problem? Call Rural Pest Solutions today. We offer as-needed services as well as a variety of treatment schedules. We're family-owned and operated, and we specialize in treating life's smallest problems. Spiders, ants, roaches, termites, mice, and more. For both residential and commercial, we're ready to solve your pest problems today. So call Rural Pest Solutions in Cashion, 405-238-6565. Proud supporter of Wildcat Athletes.
All right, welcome back to Cashion, Oklahoma, and Cashion Wildcat TV here for softball action on Labor Day, where the Cashion Wildcats find themselves down 15-6. It was a tough inning for the Cashion Wildcats here at the bottom, or I'm sorry, the top of four, as started off with a grand slam, and it just didn't stop there after that, where the Hinton Comets were able to put up 12 runs in the inning. Certainly a combination of a few bleeders here and there, and obviously a huge home run by grand slam by number two, Wheeler. But a series of errors at home and around the field certainly did not help the Cashion Wildcats. But we'll look to see if we can get them bounce back here. It looks like we've got Emily Harrell up to bat. We'll go ahead and cut to live action here. Again, want to thank our sponsors, Shape Up Fitness with Amber Lee, Gateway Realty, Anita and Kelly over there, Grain and Grage, Todd Miller, great furniture and stuff for your house. Cameron Hogan over at Cashion Clinic, Chris Gibson over at Legacy Insurance, Rural Pest Solutions. You just saw the commercial there of Jesse McCracken, does a great job. Pioneer Communications, Diesel Horse Sports and Orthopedics, Coffee Creek Church, Maple Mix and Diesel Horse, Intrust Insurance Agency, and of course all of our Cash and All Sports supporters. So with that, we've got bottom of four action here. Down 15-6. That was a tough inning. Let's see if Emily Harrell can start us off here. Swing, foul ball. Staying aggressive. Emily with a strikeout last at bat. She had a walk and a strikeout on the day. Hit by pitch. That's a good. We'll take it either way. So Harrell trots down to first base, hit by pitch. Izzy Reeves, catcher, up to bat. She's had a strikeout and a hit in the second inning. Starts off with a strike. Big shout out to my wife for getting me a Dr. Pepper. Needed that. No outs, top of four, cashing down 15-6. Swing, foul ball, nice work there by Reeves. Just a little bit off. She'll find it. She had a huge monster hit there in the second inning. Kind of helped Cashion kind of move forward in what was Cashin's big inning in the bottom of two. Hit another hit by pitch. Looks like Weathers is preferring to throw HBPs than strikes, but we'll take it. So that's two in a row. And that'll bring up second baseman Ryan Ball. Runners at first and second, Harrell and Reeves. No outs. First pitch strike. That one, I swung at that one. That looked a little low. Second pitch strike. 0-2. Ryan Ball says, okay, I got this. Lindsey Miller on deck. Pitch number three is a ball. 1-2. Nathan, can you see the hole, the divot at the pitcher's mound? It's literally like the size of the Grand Canyon. I don't even know how they're pitching through that. Outside. Ball two. 2-2. No outs. Runners at 1-2 for the Cashion Wildcats. Ryan Ball, second baseman. Working back here. Weathers pitching for the Comets. High inside. 3-2 full count. Works all the way back. Swing and a miss. Strike. And with that strike, that'll be a strikeout for Ball. That'll bring up out number one. Brings up Lindsey Miller, who's 2-for-2 on the day, I believe. Is that right? No, she is 1-for-2. Strikeout in the first inning, a hit in the second. Starts off with a strike there. One out, runners at 1-2 for the Cashion Wildcats. Bottom of four, down 15-6. See if Cashion can return the favor. Hit! It's like it's in the gap, right gap. Left fielder chasing it down. She's able to glove it for out number two. Good hit there, solid hit by Lindsey. Good job there by the left fielder to chase that down the gap. And with two outs, two on, junior Lauren Lamb up to bat. Swing, foul ball. Lauren, who was a part of that big output in the second inning for the Cashion Wildcats, actually had two at-bats. First one, she She did get out on her first one, but had a solid hit, drove in a run. Swing, hit! Third base side, it's got a chance. Woo! Just foul to the fence. Nice work there by Lamb, showing some power to go along with that speed. Just straighten it out a little bit. 0-2 count, two outs. Hi, good eye there. 1-2. Kenzie Wakefield on deck for the Cashion Wildcats. Great weather here on Labor Day. Hit, foul ball side. Great job there by the first baseman. Number 5, Finley, diving, using, looks like, all of that 6'2" frame to go out there and reach and catch it. And just like that, that's three outs. So Cashion held scoreless there in the fourth inning. They went 0 first inning, 6 in the second, 0 in the third, and 0 in the fourth, stranding 2. And just like that, we've got top of 5 action coming back to you here right soon. We'll be right back here in a minute.
Pros with Squirtle Live. Find out more at squirtle.com/stream.
Hi, welcome back to Cashion, Oklahoma. We've got Cashion Wildcat TV powered by Squirtle. We've got the home team Cashion Wildcats down by 9, 15-6 here, top of 5 here on Labor Day action. Super glad and thankful for those of you that are out here watching. My man Hunter Shepherd out there sending out a tweet about my mic. I apologize for that. Thank you. And certainly one of the things when you're just out here trying to do stuff on a Monday Labor Day, right? Here we are. Coach Chambers and the crew find themselves down big, about 9 runs, allowing 12 in that last fourth inning. Just absolute run onslaught by the Hinton Comets. Number 5 up to bat, Finley, for the Comets leading off here. Top of 5 action. Kaylee Durant pitching for the Cashion Wildcats. Finley, who made the last out at first base for the Comets on a hit by Lauren Lamb. She has 3 outs on the night. She's put the ball in play, just hasn't gotten on. So swings. The pitch, no strike there, but it's a 3-0 count. No outs. Ball four, and that sends Finley to first base. Brings up Mauk, number 11, who reached on error in the first inning, had an out, and in that last mess in the fourth inning, if I can read my notes, I think she at least had a run and a hit and a walk in that mess. Runner at one, no outs, 15-6, cashing down big, trying to hold here. He rammed the pitch, high and outside. Pitch, strike. Nice job to come back. Duran. 1-1. No outs. Top of five. Swing and a miss. Pitch there by Duran. Two strikes. It's 1-2. And we're in the fifth inning. So, strike three, nice job there by Duran, who's able to get, I believe, her second strikeout of the day on number 11, Mauk. Out number one. Brings up number four, Dahlberg, back up. She's a little slapper bunner. Left side work by number four.
4-1-1.
See if she can try to squeeze one through. She had a nice little squeeze there in the second inning. And just like that, right past Lauren Jenkins, diving Lauren Jenkins. I should have double jinxed her there. I wish I could have said something differently, but she did exactly like that in the second inning. Was able to get on base, halfway down first base line. That little hit there, it's a dangerous combination. So with that, one out. Runners at first and second for Hinton. Brings up number three, Weathers, pitcher. He's had a monster day today. Couple runs, big hits in the gap. Right past Lauren Lamb, drives in one run. Looks like she's gonna drive in another, throws it at home. Izzy Reeves cuts it off, is able to hold the runner at two. And just like that, two more runs are tacked on with a huge hit by Weathers. Double, drives in two. Number nine, Denny up to bat for the Comets. Who had a strike one. Denny had an out in the second inning. Also had a run and a hit and a run. Courtesy runner there for the pitcher. Weathers, you got number one out there pinch running. 0-1, one out. 0-2, nice pitch there by Duran. 17-6 here. Hitting up big. Cashion trying to get out of here and get back on offense. Strike three, nice work there for a second strikeout here in this inning. Great job by Kaylee Duran. Two outs. Number seven, Barrett. Swing, miss. She had a big hit. Barrett had a big hit. Early in the second inning, she got at least seven, and then hit by pitch in the fifth inning. I'm sorry, the fourth inning. Hit. Pass to Emily Harrell, short, runner going home. Ball can't scoop it, runner going to two, looking for the tag. Jenkins there. And that hit drives in another run. Barrett. hit to right field. Really Nance there. Jenkins running. Nance with the out. Out number three. And that ends the inning, so a lot of action there on that play. Jenkins basically running about 50 yards to catch that. She had it tracked down. Raylene Nance right there with the catch for out number three. Jenkins getting a talking to from her sister. We'll see if she's okay. Looks like she's okay. And with that, Cashin holds, hitting to two runs that inning. Oh, I'm sorry. Yes, two runs, I believe. And we'll look to go to the bottom of five action here down 17-6. We'll have a quick timeout. We'll be right back here on Cashion Wildcat TV.
Gateway Realty is a mother-daughter team that has a heart for small-town life. Both Anita and Kelly were born and raised in Cashion and are still raising their families
here. That is mine.
Their family homesteaded in Cashion in 1908, and it's been home ever since. Anita and Kelly know this town, love this town, and would love to help make this your home, too. For a friendly face and trustworthy knowledge, call these hometown girls at 405-641-7388. Go Wildcats!
Back to Cashion, Oklahoma. Cashion Wildcat Television here, powered by Squirrel. Thanks so much for joining us here on a Labor Day Monday. Softball action here as the Cashion Wildcats find themselves down 17-6. Huge inning there, a couple innings ago. 12-run inning for the visiting Hinton Comets to take a big, big lead. Kenzie Wakefield will start off the inning here, top of or bottom of five for the Wildcats. We've got ball one. Strike one. Weather's for the Comets certainly heating up. She's done well these last few innings, actually holding Cashion to no runs in the third and fourth inning. Inside, ball two. 2-1. One count. Kenzie Wakefield earlier in the day she had a huge hit in the second inning. Started off that big monster inning for the Cashion Wildcats where they got six runs down the first base side. All four. We've got a runner. Nice job by Wakefield, the designated hitter, to get the walk there. And that'll bring up Raylene Nance, right fielder, who made that last out for us. Shows the bunt, fouls that one off. Really, Nancy's also a cheerleader as well. We've got a lot of dual sport, dual activity, triple activity girls out here for the Cashion Wildcats. Strike two, showed bunt, pulled back. 0-2 or 1-2 count. 0-2 or 1-2. And with that, we have strikeout, one out. I like Nance's aggressiveness. Certainly, team keep our eyes down in the zone. So with that, Ella Sutkin's back up. Ella's had a good day today. Hit a walk.
in the dirt. Pitch one, ball one. One out, runner at first, Kenzie Wakefield for the Cashion Wildcats here, bottom of five, down 17-6. Looking to get a few runs here to kind of chip away at this huge hit and lead. Swing, foul ball. Can't do it all at once. You have to make sure and do the right things, the little things. Obviously get the outs when they need to, but get on base and figure out how to get on base and how to get those runs in. Doesn't matter how. Lauren Jeekin, second baseman, on deck. Third pitch in the dirt, ball two. 2-1 count, one out for the Cashion Wildcats. Ella Sutkin. Inside, 3-1. Second smile, she knew it. But it was outside. It's a tough pitch. It's a good pitch. Give credit to Weathers there for hitting that corner. 3-2, one out. Full count. Weathers working back. Pitch down the middle, hit right back to pitcher. She's looking to get the force out. Not there. Nice work there by the Cashion Wildcats. Good base running by Kenzie Wakefield. Weathers, I'm not sure what she was looking for. She saw the second baseman roll up. There was no cover at two. Short was getting there. But with that, we've got runners at first and second. We'll go ahead and give the fielder's choice on that last at-bat for Ella. Hi, the Jenkins, ball one, one out. Cash is down 17-6 here, bottom of five. Got Emily Harrell on deck. Swing and miss. Good swing. I like the approach by Jenkins. Just needed to keep her head down on that one. Really wanted to hit that one hard. 1-2. I'm sorry, 0-1. Hit. Foul ball. She hit some car out there. Poor person out there parked. That's all right. Be okay. Again, thanks to all those folks that have come out. We've got a packed house here, both the junior high and varsity games. Celebrating Labor Day out here, Cashion style, with some softball. Bottom of five. Pitch is high. Ball one. 1-2, one out. Bottom of five, Cashion down 17-6. Runners at first and second. We've got Sumkin at first, Kenzie Wakefield at two. Jenkins working at base. Change up, high. 2-2 count, one out. Jenkins battling back. Swing, hit, second base side, through the gaps, goes to score Wakefield. Nice job watching it. Oh, could have had a chance to score, but good work there by Wakefield. Excellent base running. Good shot there by number two. Wheeler, who had the grand slam earlier, coming all the way into home plate, cutting off Wakefield and stopping the run. But with that, we have bases loaded. 1-2-3, one out. And we've got three-hole hitter Emily Harrell. Great hit there by Jenkins, by the way. We've seen a lot of plays right behind second base, most of them bleeders by the comments. That one by Jenkins. An absolute rip down. Hit by Harrell. Pass short. That'll score a run. Sutkin will look. She'll come down to score. She will. She's safe. Nice work there by Harrell with an absolute hammer to center field. And that will score two runs for the Cashion Wildcats as they cut in this lead with one out. Two runners. We've got two runners still on with Izzy Reeves up to bat. Izzy Reeves with a hit by pitch last inning. Inside pitch for ball one. Just had a strikeout and a hit earlier in the day. Had a huge hit.
See if she can replicate that, what she did in the second inning for the Cashion Wildcats. Right ball on deck. 17-8, Cashion down 9. One out. In the dirt for ball two. And again, there's no 9-run hit out there. So the idea is they just have to continue to work, chip away. Work weathers the pitcher. She's throwing strikes, just find the pitch. And Cashin's shown offense all day and all season. Swing. Miss, strike one. They've got Jenkins at two, Harrell at one. Pitch swing hits the pitcher. Fielder's choice. She'll go one. That'll move runners over. So Izzy Reed for the fielder choice, out number two. And I'll bring up Ryan Ball with two outs. Jenkins at third, Harrell at two. Pitch is high. Ryan Ball with ball. Ryan's had two walks, one in the first inning, second in the second inning, and her last at-bat was a strikeout. I think watching ball four, I'm sorry, in the fourth inning. So that's ball two. Inside pitch, strike one, 2-1. Swing, hit, right field, drops, that'll score two. And just like that, Ryan Ball's on safe. Good work, no give up from this Cashion Wildcat team. Staying alive here with two outs. Drop into shallow right field for Ryan Ball, and that scores two. Up to bat, Lindsay Miller. On deck, we've got Lauren Lamb. Lindsay with a strikeout and a hit and another out. Foul ball, left side. For strike one. Ball one. Two outs for Miller, third baseman. Runner at one, Ryan Ball. Weathers with his pitch. Good pitch. She's got good speed. Good hit in the comments. And that brings up strike two. Two outs, two balls, two strikes, two outs. Cashing 17-10 here, down seven. Chipping away at that lead. Nice four-run inning for him. In the dirt. Ball will run. She's down. And she'll be called out for stealing. And so that will end the side for the Cashion Wildcats. A productive inning. Lindsay Miller will stay up to bat next inning. I think Ryan kind of double-guessed herself that last time, and that was just enough to get thrown out. Good call there by the umpire. So with that, we are at the top of six, Cashion down 17-10. Four-run innings for the Cashion Wildcats there. Let's see if we can hold them on defense and get back. We'll go a quick timeout. We'll be right back here on CWTV.
Cashion Shape Up Fitness is locally owned and operated with no contracts or sign-up fees. Our rates start at only $30 per month, and we have tanning available. Everything you need to work on your health and fitness. So contact Amber Lee to sign up today, 405-538-8248. And don't forget to check us out on Facebook, Cashion Shape Up Fitness.
Welcome back to Cashion, Oklahoma, here on CWTV Softball Style, here on Labor Day. Your Cashion Wildcats are down 7 runs, 17-10, to the visiting Hinton Comets. It's been a back-and-forth game. Believe it or not, with the score 17-10, there's actually been a lot of defense. Kaylee Duran pitching for the Cashion Wildcats today. She's got a couple strikeouts. Number 8 up to bat for the Hinton Comets. First swing strike. Number 8 coming in to hit for Gomez, number 15, who's actually had a pretty good day. Hit down third base line. Lindsey Miller on the scoop. Throw to first, and there's out number 1. Nice work there by the sophomore to sophomore. Again, super young team for the Cashion Wildcats, learning every game, getting better every game. Nice job there by Miller. Nice snag there by Sutton for out number 1. Pitch, swing, stop by Harrell, good scoop by the short, out number 2. Kind of like that, 3 pitches, 2 outs. Nice work there by Harrell. It's been fantastic at short. Well struck ball there by number 21, Kurloff. That brings up Findlay, number 5. Findlay's had a few outs, had a walk last inning and a run. First pitch in the dirt for ball 1. Top of 6 action here. Cashin with 2 outs on the Hinton Comets. Hit, back to Harrell, short, nice scoop. And that'll be out number 3. 3 up, 3 down for the Cashin Wildcats. Exactly what Coach Chambers needed and wanted. Let's see if the girls can go back out there and get to keep the offensive sticks going. Nice job by Cashin there. A couple plays there by Emily Harrell at short. And one by Lindsey Miller at third. As Hinton goes 3 up, 3 down, leading up for the Cashion Wildcats will be Lindsey Miller back up. As Ryan Ball was caught stealing from first to second to end the last inning, what was a productive inning for the Cashion Wildcats where they got four runs in. So that will go to a quick timeout. Be right back.
I'm Todd Miller, and this is Grain & Grange, the coolest furniture store you've never heard of. Come see us.
All right, welcome back to Cashion, Oklahoma. It's Cashion Wildcat Softball here on Labor Day. Cashion finds themselves down 17-10 to the Hinton Comets. If it wasn't for that 12-run inning, Nathan, in the top of 4, Cashin certainly would be celebrating a lead right now, but chipping away, scoring 6 runs in the second, 4 runs in the fifth. Cashin here now top of bottom of 6. Lindsey Miller lead off here with Lauren Lamb on deck, looking to again continue to chip away at that big lead by the Hinton Comets. Pitching for the Comets is Weathers. Swing hit down to shortstop, right past the glove, and Lindsey Miller's on. We'll score that a hit. Well struck ball by Lindsey Miller, first pitch. And just like that, we've got a runner. Lindsey Miller at first base, bringing up Lauren Lamb, number 5 center fielder. No outs. Mackenzie Wakefield on deck. Nice job there by Lindsay Miller. Well hit ball. Lauren Lamb taking her time. I like it. Kind of icing the pitcher there a little bit. Hit over the snap. Great job. Well struck ball by Lauren Lamb. Shortstop to her credit, puts her glove up, snow cones it, comes back. And I don't blame Lindsay Miller. I would have been running too on that one. And so with that, she was able to get the out at first as well for the double play. And just like that, two outs for Kenzie Wakefield. Wakefield on the day has a hit and a walk, one for one. In the dirt, someone was hit by a pitch there. Two outs. Again, well struck ball by Lauren Lamb, and again, kudos to the shortstop. You know, sometimes there's always a little bit of luck involved, but I think she got her glove up. She hustled, got her glove up in the right position, and it stuck right at the top there for the first out and the double play at first. Ball. 3-0 for Kenzie Wakefield. In the dirt for ball four. Kenzie finds herself at first base. And that'll bring up Rayleigh Nance with two outs. Rayleigh with the strikeout at her last at bat. Rayleigh will show a little bunt, a little slap bunt. Hits on both sides. Showing bunt here. Hits away into the second. Nice job by Nance. Will move Wakefield all the way to two. Nice job by Seven. Showing some power there out of the bunt stance. Nice work there by Rayleigh Nance, who gets the hit. Moving Wakefield to two with two outs. Cashion threatening with Ella Sumpkin leadoff up to bat. And what would have been, right? You know, a lot of what ifs in this situation. If you get that double play there, start off the inning. So bottom of six, Cashion down 17-10. First pitch strike there for Sumpkin, first base. Ella has a hit, a walk, an out, and a fielder's choice where she was able to get on and score and eventually score a run. And that four-run output in the fourth inning. Swing, pop up to third, and that'll end the side. Right off the inside handle. And so, stranding two. Cashin's held scoreless there in that inning. And we move to top of seven, last inning here for the Cashin Wildcats. As they try to get the side out and get back up to bat. Down 17-10. Go to a quick commercial, be right back.
Dr. Matt Dieselhorst at Dieselhorst Sports and Orthopedics can help you get game day ready. Dr. Dieselhorst works with athletes of all ages, taking a coordinated approach to accelerate return to play and maximize athletic performance. His work with pros in sports training, injury prevention, bracing, functional rehabilitation, and imaging works seamlessly with his medical and surgical expertise. Get started by going to Dieselhorst Sports and Orthopedics. Let Dr. Matt Dieselhorst get you back on the field, backing all Oklahoma athletes on the field and off.
At Maples.
All right, welcome back to Cashion, Oklahoma. I'm Neiman Abavi, my man Nathan Abavi on the camera, doing work in between Snapchats and whatever else, trying to do his business, socializing here in the dugout. I appreciate him sticking it out and doing the camera work for all of us. He's a trooper here. He could be at home doing something, hanging out the pool, but he's here with me, so thank you. So thank you, Nathan. Up to bat for the Hinton Comets here. Number 11, deep shot to right center, hits the fence. Lamb trying to get it into two. Cut off there by Jenkins. And first pitch to a bagger there for number 11, Malk. Nice shot there. No outs here. as the Cashion Wildcats look to hang on. Mack will get the runner for her, as this is the last inning. No more defense for her, I guess. Or she can come back in. That's right, additional player. She can come back in one more time. I'm learning softball rules. So number four up the bat, Dahlberg, she comes back in. A little small ball action here. She'll look to swing, slap, strike. Good job there by Kaylee Duran. Coach Hannah here for the Comets, mixing a lot of small ball. And it's got some girls who can absolutely mash it too as well. Right down the third base line, Lindsay Miller with the grab. Nice throw to Sundkin for out number one. We'll move the runner over to third base with one out. Number three, pitcher Weathers up to bat. Top of seven, 17-10, cashing down seven runs. Weathers with a big hit and run. She's going to pop one out to right. Right center, right in between the gap. Great hustle there by Lamb. Throw in from Nance with the cutoff, and that'll get her all the way to third base. Kudos to Lamb. Excellent hustle. She's getting her a couple of high fives through the air from the dugout. She did. It was a great effort there to try to get that, even get a hand from the field ump. Courtesy runner for the pitcher. Number one comes back in. That's number nine up to bat to Denny. You had a strikeout last at bat. Pitch inside. Ball one. One out. Pop up. Sutkin's got a chance. Comes back in fair. She snags it. Catches it for out number two, which is a big out. Good work there by the sophomore tracking that one down. That one started foul, came back over about 10 yards fair. She was able to move with it and get the glove on there for out number two. And so with that, we've got number seven, Barrett. First pitch strike there for Kaylee. One. Hit. In another gap shot. Goodness gracious. Hinton's hit every spot needed. Ryan Ball in with the throw in to two. Jenkins with the glove. Holds the runner at two. Nice shot there by number seven, Barrett, with the double. And that'll bring up leadoff Wheeler, who has a grand slam, a walk. A few runs and a few hits in here. She's done well. Low and outside. Good pitch there by Kaylee. Don't want to give her anything. Hit. Nance in right field. She misses it. Goes to the wall. Well struck. That'll score a run. Looking for a triple. Maybe inside the park home run. Throw in by Jenkins. Backup's there. By Duran, she's got a chance if she throws it. Oh, she doesn't. Still would have had a chance as she missed the bag. But another big hit by Wheeler. She gets another, I believe, another triple to add to her grand slam. And that'll score a run. Number eight back up for the swing, foul ball, strike. One, two count, two outs for Duran. Looking to get that third out here. Swing and a miss, and there it is, strike three. Nice work by Duran, and that ends the side. And here we are, bottom of seven. Cashing down 20-10. If we ever needed an 11-run inning, this might be it, right, Nathan? 11-run inning?
Maybe.
Okay. So with that, we'll go a quick timeout. Be right back here on Cashion Wildcat TV.
Fix and Diesel Horse, we've helped a lot of people, and our goal was to treat each and every person like a friend. And as a friend, we've got your back, always. We understand what you're going through. Being lawyers is what we do, but it's not all that we are. We care. We'll stand beside you throughout the entire legal process, not just as lawyers, but as your friends. We are Maples, Nix, and Diesel Horst, and we are here to help.
Have a pest problem? Call Rural Pest Solutions today. We offer as-needed services as well as a variety of treatment schedules. We're family-owned and operated, and we specialize in treating life's smallest problems. Spiders, ants, roaches, termites, mice, and more. For both residential and commercial, we're ready to solve your pest problems today. So call Rural Pest Solutions in Cashion, 405-238-6565. Proud supporter of Wildcat Athletes.
All right, welcome back to Cashion, Oklahoma, and Labor Day softball here, where the Cashion Wildcats find themselves down 10-7, bottom of 7 action here. This is it right here for the Cashion Wildcats. Leading off for the Wildcats will be Lauren Jenkins, and then we've got Emily Harrell on deck. Certainly need a lot of offense here. And, it, you know, Cashion's had it. You know, scoring 10 runs is no easy feat. And, Hinton comments throwing two pretty good pitchers at them, Gomez and Weathers. Weathers has finished the game, and she's been strong last four innings, only giving up four runs to the Cashion Wildcats. Again, I want to thank all of our awesome sponsors, Shape Up Fitness, Gateway Realty, Grain & Grange, Cashion Clinic, Rural Pest Solutions, Pioneer, First Pitch Ball, as well as Diesel Horse Sports and Orthopedics, Coffee Creek Church, Maple Nixon, Diesel Horse, Interest Insurance Agency, and, of course, Cashion All Sports. My man Chris Gibson over at Legacy Insurance. Deacons 1-0, no outs. Swing. Oh, I'm sorry, strike. I wanted to say she needs a swing, but that was 1-1. She'll take strike there on pitch number two from Weathers. Outside, ball two, good eye, 2-1. Cashinich needs base runners, however you can do it. Swinging bunts, gaps, errors, whatever, we'll take it. In the dirt, ball three. Or actually, I say low. Hold up. Got a loose spray paint can lid. Swing, hit, right field. Great job by Jenkins. To see if she gets there in time. She does. Great job by Jenkins. Absolutely having a great day behind the plate. Second hit in a row. She's got three hits on the day to go with her first inning strikeout. So 3-for-4. Fantastic work by Jenkins. And that's a good start for the Cashion Wildcats. Bringing up Emily Harrell, sophomore. Three-hole hitter. Emily's had a walk, a strikeout, a hit by pitch, and a hit. Hit last inning. In the fifth inning, I should say. Outside and high for ball one. Izzy Reeves on deck. Certainly a good start by the Cashion Wildcats, and they had a great start. They had two runners, basically had a runner on, Lindsey Miller on last inning, and Ryan Ball, an unfortunate shortstop, made an unbelievable play for a double play. Harrell with the swing and the foul ball, a little ahead of that one. 1-1, no outs. Swing, smash! He's got a chance! Hits the wall! Jenkins coming to third. Harrell with an absolute bomb. She murdered that thing to left field. Hit the very top of the fence. Could have cleared it. Would have been a two-run shot. Nonetheless, it's a double for her, and that brings up Izzy Reeves. No outs for the Cashion Wildcats here. Bottom of seven. This is it. It's do or die. We've got Izzy Reeves at bat, second base, Ryan Ball on deck. Runners at second and third, just an absolute mash by Emily Harrell. Hit. Reeves will pop it up. It has a chance to bleed. Tag up is there. Jenkins down. She'll make it home. Harrell will be held at two, and that'll score a run. So sack fly there by Reeves will bring in a run. Cashin will move closer, 20 to 11. Ryan Ball up to bat with one out. Had a hit last at bat. Strike. Seems like Weathers has done well against Ball, throwing that inside pitch for a strike every time. First pitch. One out, 20 to 11. Hit down the right base side. For those of you helping with the scoring live online, thank you so much. And all of course, all of our folks that are watching. So high up there, ball two, 2-1, one out. Bottom of seven, Cashion down 20-11. Runner at two, Emily Harrell on a monster hit to the wall. Change up. Gets a piece of that. 1-2. Change up again. It'll be a strikeout for out number two. I swear every time they go and look at their wrist guard, you know it's going to be a changeup. So with that, brings up Lindsay Miller. Foul ball. Lindsay Miller with a hit last at bat. Two outs, 0-1, runner at two. Swing, change up, foul ball. Ball one, 1-2, two outs, bottom of seven here. Cashin needing a bunch of runs here. We've got Lindsay Miller up the bat, third base. We've got Lauren Lamb on deck. Swing, foul ball. Lindsay Miller waiting for her pitch. She's staying in there. 1-2. Foul ball hangs up there with the changeup. Nice work there by the sophomore. And again, kudos to Coach Chambers. It's just such a young team. So many freshmen and sophomores that are, playing pivotal roles for this team. Obviously, we know about the juniors. I think Kaylee Duran maybe the only senior on the team. Again, growing and learning with each game. Big hit, right side. Has a chance to drop. Just foul. Good work there by Lindsay Miller. Quality at bat. Making Weathers work on every single pitch. Still up 1-2. Did we call a change up on this one, Nathan?
No.
You gonna come fastball?
Yeah.
You gonna try to knock her out? I call change up. See what happens here. See, Lindsay's done a great job of hanging tight in there. In the dirt, stealing. Harrell all the way to third. Nice work there by Harrell. Told you. 2-2-2. Two strikes, two out, two balls, two outs here. We got a runner at third, Emily Harrell, on that huge hit to left field. Lindsay Miller hanging tight. Swing, foul ball. Catcher Russell's great job there by the catcher, and that will end the game. Nice work there by the catcher, number 21, Kurloff. And with that, Cashion falls 20-11. Not after a battle. Good work there by the Cashion Wildcats as they certainly had the sticks. Clean up some things in the infield, and you know, it will have been a very competitive game. But as we mentioned, they have a very young team, learning with every game. And these are things that Coach Chambers can take to learn and grow with as they continue to move through this season. So with that, I'm Neiman Abavi. Thank you so much, my man Nathan Abavi on the camera. You're gonna hit me up right here. We do have a final 20-11 here with the Cashion Wildcats. Fall on Labor Day. We appreciate you guys joining us. We thank all of our sponsors, and we really appreciate our administration, of course, Coach Chambers, allowing us to come out here and film in the dugout. For all of you at home, enjoying the weekend. Continue to have a great weekend. We've got a bunch of softball this week, as well as Friday night action with the high schoolers going out to Minco for week two, game three action. I'm Nathan Abavi. For Nathan Abavi, thank you so much for joining us here on CWTV. Have a good one, and God bless.